Hello and welcome to AirsoftTech.dk. In today's episode, I will be taking my burst mode MOSFET. I will be downloading the code for the MOSFET from my website and uploading it to the MOSFET. And then I'm going to show you how the MOSFET works using one of my guns. So if you're interested in how the MOSFET works, keep watching. Before we start, we have to download the code. First, jump onto the webpage, AirsoftTech.dk. Go to the Projects and Tech. Find the Burst Mode MOSFET DIY. It has a link to the project page. In the project page, we roughly go through how to make it, how the wiring goes. We have of course the videos and a step-by-step guide to how you can make it yourself without using the PCBs. When you get to the end here, we have the option to download the code. I recommend using the simple version. When you get the simple version to work, you can always download the advanced version and start playing around with the code for that one. Right click that, save link as, and I have my folder ASCU demo, save to that folder, and this is the file that have been downloaded. What you do is you make a new folder with the same name. I have that here. This file, you have to rename that, and the extension txt, remove that, and instead type in INO. Do you want to change it? Yes, I want to change it. And now you can see it's an Arduino file. Put that inside the Burst MOSFET symbol folder. I have done that already. And if you have the Arduino IDE installed, it should open. If you do not have the Arduino IDE installed, go to the Arduino webpage and install it. Then you can open up the Arduino sketch. Ta-da! And here you have the Arduino sketch. And on up here you have the digital pin number, digital pin 5. So the MOSFET gate should be connected to gate 5. The Arduino. Let's go up to my drawing. Yes, my drawing says right here, gate 5 is connected. The analog 0 is this one, the trigger pin. Down here we have the values for the voltage divider. It has to be either a 100 and a 10 kilo ohms, or a 10 kilo ohms and a 1 kilo ohm. And these two resistors is, this resistor here is the top one. Currently on the drawing here, I have this set up like so. A 10 kilo ohm as the big one and a 1 kilo ohm as the small one. And you have the max on time, which I will be showing you how to adjust that value when we have the gun connected. There is not very much room here, so before I connect the MOSFET to the gun, I will connect the USB wire. I will connect the gun to the Arduino first mode A is U, and the trigger wire needs to be connected as well. Now I grab my LiPo battery and connect that as well. And as you can see, now the MOSFET turns on. So now I have connected the Arduino burst mode unit to the gun and to the battery. Now I need to connect it to the computer. Like so. If I, for example, write 400, it means 400 milliseconds for each time I pull the trigger. So now I hit the arrow up here, which is the upload button. And down here you can see the code is compiling. Now it's uploading. And now it is done uploading. So now let's go to the gun, pull the trigger. As you can probably hear, it now shoots around 6 shots each time. So we go back in, I adjust it to 200, and this is how you need to play around to find the timing values that works for your gun. Now it's 200, upload the code once again. When it says down here, it says done uploading in the corner down here. We can go to try it out again. And now it shoots perfectly, 3 shots for each pull of the trigger. And this is my MOSFET that I'm using today. So basically what I do is I take the battery and connect it to the MOSFET. The MOSFET has the signal wire hooked up and the motor wires. And as you can hear, it fires quite nicely. If I put it on auto, then it fires semi. So now I'm going to remove the battery and plug out the MOSFET. Instead, I'm going to plug in the burst mode MOSFET. Plug in the signal cable and plug in the battery. You can see the MOSFET lights up and see me working perfectly. Full auto, 3 shots and it stops. 3 shots and it stops. And it will not fire again until I release the trigger, and then it can fire once again. So that is the burst MOSFET. When done, just unplug it, just like any other MOSFET.
So now I have a regular MOSFET for when I do not want burst mode, and I have a burst mode MOSFET for when I want the burst feature. That is how I'm going to be using it. Now my M4 has gotten burst mode using this new MOSFET. So the next step will be to make sure that the MOSFET works with every kind of gun always and is easy to set up, and also switch between burst mode and full auto. All of that is basically just code. So in the next video I will be going through the code and I will show you the features of the code and make some modifications so that the code can switch between full auto and burst mode. And later on I will also be adding more features to the MOSFET. So if you like my project, thumbs up, subscribe and tell all your friends. The more followers I get, the more videos I will make. Thank you for watching.